With that discussed, now let's move on to calculating natural frequencies of bolted structures. We first solve the equations for a static system to calculate the modified stiffness matrix due to bolt preload. This includes the stress stiffening matrix and may include modified structure stiffness due to other nonlinearities. This modified stiffness matrix is then used in an undamped dynamic system which is under no external loads. These equations are solved to calculate the natural frequencies, also known as modal frequencies, and their corresponding mode shapes. This is called as modal analysis. In Ansys Mechanical, we can use linear perturbation in conjunction with modal analyses. Linear perturbation method is used to calculate an appropriate stiffness matrix to be used in the modal analysis. The solution matrices may be calculated from a stress-free state, or in case of a pre-stress system, they may come from a transient or static analysis that we refer to as base analysis. If the base analysis is linear, or if it uses small deformation, we can still calculate natural frequencies of a pre-stress system. In that case, we add the stress stiffening matrix to original system stiffness. This analysis considers pre-stress but ignores all other nonlinearities. On the other hand, if the base analysis is nonlinear, then the system stiffness changes with the deformation. So, if we wish to calculate the natural frequencies of the system at a certain state of deformation, then we freeze that nonlinear state, calculate the tangent stiffness matrix, and then use that tangent stiffness matrix in the linear perturbation. We do this because, as the name suggests, linear perturbation is a linear analysis and we need to linearize any existing nonlinearities from the base analysis, since a modal analysis is also linear. Now let's see how to perform this analysis using Ansys Mechanical. In Ansys Mechanical, we can create a workflow to perform the linear perturbation analysis. You simply need to insert structural system, static or transient, on the project page and drag and drop modal system over solution of the structural system. This will automatically create links to share and transfer data for engineering data, geometry, model and solution cells. Notice that result cell of static module is connected to setup cell of modal module, implying that the results of static analysis are used as basis for modal analysis. When we open mechanical application, we can see that the pre-stress static structural object is created in the outline tree. Linking structural system solution and modal setup cells ensures that necessary static conditions and restart files will be available for the perturbation analysis. We mentioned earlier that the linear perturbation analysis can be viewed as an iteration of a base, linear or nonlinear analysis. All of the linear or nonlinear effects from the base analysis are taken into account and frozen so that the perturbation loads can generate structural results linearly by using the frozen solution matrices and material properties. Ansys restart capability is used in the base analysis in order to automate the whole process. In the base analysis, we can set up restart controls in order to generate tangent stiffness matrix. Any point from a static or transient analysis can be perturbed. Just make sure you have restart files for that point. In a bolted assembly, the contact between bolt head or nut and the mating face is usually nonlinear or frictional contact in structural analysis. So how do we treat that nonlinear contact in linear perturbation analysis? A few options are available. The first one is true status, which uses the current contact status from the restart snapshot. If the previous run for parent static structural is nonlinear, then the nonlinear contact status at the point of restart is frozen and used throughout the linear perturbation analysis. The second option is force sticking, which uses sticking contact stiffness for the frictional contact pairs, even when the status is sliding, that is, no sliding status is allowed. This option only applies to contact pairs whose frictional coefficient is greater than zero. The final option is force bounded. This option uses bonded contact stiffness and status for contact pairs that are in a closed state, that is sticking or sliding. But what about the loads? How do we treat loads and supports in a linear perturbation analysis? When you link modal analysis to a structural analysis, all structural loading conditions are deleted from the base analysis. All displacement constraints are kept in conducting the linear perturbation analysis. All non-zero displacement constraints are set to zero. In bolted assembly, we need to make sure that the bolts are locked after static structural analysis. Otherwise, bolt halves may separate in modal analysis. For the bolted assembly analysis, we want to set large deflection on so that we can have updated geometry based on base analysis. Once the model is solved, we can post-process the results. Although the displacements, stresses, and strains will be calculated correctly in the modal analysis, the final deformed shape in mechanical will be based upon the initial geometry.